everyone, this is Alicia, also known as AVP. Back with another gaming video. I haven't done one of these in quite some time. So I'm going to see if we can wrap up Season 7 of my Hunger Games. In case you guys didn't know, basically what I do is I get eight different random celebrities of different movies, television, books, whatever, and I basically put them all in my house, and I basically see of those eight, and normally it's four guys, four girls, and I get them from, like I said, different genres of different things that I'm enjoying. Sometimes it's a made-up version of something that maybe a toy I played with as a child. So basically, with these eight celebrities, I have them die in various ways, and basically they have to compete for meals, for beds, and they can get punished or they can be rewarded based on their performance and stuff like that. And so I haven't done one of these in quite some time. So we are on Season 7, in case you guys didn't know. I've done 6 prior seasons. Let's look over who I have. For this season, we have Jessica Fletcher, who is from the Murder, She Wrote movies of sorts. And there's also some games and everything like that. Next is Truly Scrumptious, who is from the Chitty Chitty Bang Bang movie. Below them is Tony, who is from the West Side Story movie. Next to him is Raoul de Chagny, who is from the Phantom of the Opera book, and also from the movies that are related to the Phantom of the Opera. On the right side, we have Jack Tripper, who is from the Three's Company television series, played by John Ritter. Next to him is Rolfe, who is from the Sound of Music film. Below that is Sophie Sheridan, who is from the Mamma Mia films. And next is a grown-up version of Wendy Moira Angela Darlin, who is from the Pan films and also the book preview for an upcoming season. In upcoming Season 8, we have Tanya Baker, who is from the A-Team series. Next is Obi-Wan Kenobi, who is from the Star Wars films. Next is Kelly Garrett, and she is from the Charlie's Angels series and also from the movies. Next is Bert, who is from the Mary Poppins books and movies as well. Below that is Miss Frizzle, who is from the Magic School Bus television show. Next is going to be a grown-up version of Oliver Twist, since I choose not to do children or teens because it wouldn't be fair to them, because the children and teens typically have to go to school. And especially if it's a child, you have to sort of worry about child services taking away the kid. So, that's why I'm going to make him a grown-up. Next is Jane Jetson, who is from the Jetson series. And next will be a human version of Genie from the Aladdin films. Here's going to be our all-stars for Season 9. These are the different people that have won from the previous season. The first one is going to be Dorothy Gale, who is from the Wizard of Oz books. And also the movies that were related to the Wizard of Oz as well. Next is going to be Lex Luthor, who is from the various Superman stories, movies, television shows. Kent, who is from the Superman films and also television shows, comics, etc. Next is Biff Tannen, who is from the Back to the Future films. Next is Willy Wonka, who is from the Charlie and the Chocolate movies and the books and also the film. Excuse me. And then the last but not least is James Bond, who is from the books and also from the movies as well. So whoever wins this season will move on to the all-star round. And then when we have our winner from Season 8, then we will have all of those 8 competitors go against one another. And we'll see who is the best of the best. So that's the thing that's so pretty cool about this show, because we never know who's going to survive, who's not going to survive. Now here's who we are currently dealing with for this season, because we've already lost some of them already. We've already lost Jessica Fletcher, we've already lost Truly Scrumptious, we've already lost Raoul, we've already lost Jack Tripper, we've already lost Rolfe, and we've also, let's see, Jessica, Truly Scrumptious, Raoul, Jack, and Rolfe. So, The majority of the males have already died, sadly. And we've only got two females left and one male. So we've got Tony from the West Side Story left, and we also have Sophie from the Mamma Mia films. And we also have Wendy, who is the grown-up version of her. But like I said, when I do these things, I typically do an adult version of these kind of things. And like I said, when I do these kind of games, they're a little bit long and everything like that, because it takes a while for them to load up on the screen and everything like that. But basically, I give commentary when I'm doing these kind of things. So if you really don't want to tune in and see what happens, you can just stay for the thumbnail and see who I list as the winner or what happened, basically, because I try to give a little overview of what happened, basically, in that. So if you're still interested in seeing what happens, let's sit back and enjoy and see what happens. Because, like I said, I never know what's going to happen. I'd see it along with you guys. I mean, I create these characters myself. There's not any technically in the gallery since I'm using Sims 2, the Ultimate Collection. And basically, I get certain costumes and certain hairstyles. I get them from the gallery, the Sims resource, and mod the Sims. But other than that, I basically create and everything myself, the Sims that are going to be in it. And I have, I believe, about, let's see, how many seasons do I have already planned out? So you guys can be prepared. I tentatively have 15 seasons planned, but if you guys have ideas for future seasons, let me know. I have some already planned out. And another thing that I do about these games and stuff like that is I try to put them in a different neighborhood each time. And like I said, they have to compete over beds, they have to compete over meals. Basically pure chaos, because you never know what's going to happen with our Sims. Because Sims, they'll have a way of having a mind of their own. But it's pretty intense on what happens with the challenges, because some of the challenges could be something as simple as a log rolling contest where they have to stand on a log to see who can survive the longest, or a spinning sphere kind of challenge to see who can do it without gaining a, you know, who can do it by gaining a body skill the fastest. And some of the death challenges have been like Murphy bed ones, some of them have been satellites. We've had drownings, we've had burn-ins. So basically I try to do it without too many cheats, basically. And like I said, we never know what's going to happen with our Sims, because some of them have a little bit of an interesting experience on what happens, because some of them you think are going to die and it is pure chaos. Because there have been seasons where I thought it was going to be just one or two that I lost, and I ended up losing five of them. Because that's what happened with the drowning situation earlier this season, where I thought it was going to be just maybe, say, three of, you know, one or two, and it ended up being three, and it was, like, really crazy. And then the following season, I think it was going to be maybe one, and then it turned out to be, I'm looking this over, and it looks like it was going to be, it was two of them. And like I said, it's pure chaos that transpires with my Sims. But like I said, I've got other seasons written down. And like I said, season 9 is going to be my all-star one. But the season one after this one, as you saw, was Kelly Garrett from Charlie's Angels, Obi-Wan Kenobi, Tanya Baker, Bert, Miss Frizzle, A Grown-Up Oliver Twist, Jane Jetson, and Genie from Aladdin. Because like I said, I never know who's going to be. I try not to do any kids, because kids are, they have the risk of being taken away from child services, and so to avoid that kind of risk from happening in the game, I basically just have them as an adult, and I say, okay, they grew up, and this is what's happened to them, because I age them a little bit faster. I mean, for example, Tony was still a teenager somewhat when he died in West Side Story, and so I aged him up a bit, making him an adult, so to speak. I mean, like I said, this is my own version, and I always try to make them all around the same age range, like Jessica Fletcher. I understand that she's much older, actually, in the television series, but the thing is, I always try to keep them all around the same age range. It plays it safer, a little bit easier that way for me. And certain ones, we really don't know too much about what they were like when they got to be a certain age. Truly scrumptious, when we see her in Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, we really don't know what she's like, because we only see her as this young adult interacting with the children and the father.
Oh, Miyaga. Hina, Hina, Hina. Oh!
Kashvi. Flamdu? Flamdu noshne? A gubla, nashnabove. Marakwai. Oh, a gadashnava.
Lugna, flat. Amate ish.
Nashnava?
Kashvi.
Someone's gone out fishing. Someone's high and dry. Someone's on a mission to the lonely Lorelei. Some folks got a vision of a castle in the sky. And I'm left stranded, wondering why. You and me together, nothing feels so good. Even if
I never left the
neighborhood.
I won't need a castle, they got castles in Versailles.
Grazie, Von!
Dana.
Med la tosh, das das du?
Ah, wisch ni!
Med la tosh, das das du?
Ah, chafna! Telin saze?
Ah, ni afa!
Sizner.
Ah, sí?
It's noisy.
Thank you.
For some who don't understand our purpose, they may not understand our praise. We as a family in Jesus' name would like to tell you the reason why we sing. Why do we sing?
honor, honor.
For time. Me estou fambada. Me com galerinha.
Ah, Lancha, Callie. When a group.
A tope! A tope! Come, com toda baixa. Estou fambada. E com galerinha.
Death is an angel sent down from above. Sent for the birds of the flowers we love. For in heaven's own way, each soul is a flower in the master's bouquet.
Gathering flowers.
A tope, a tope. Come on, cut the bajo. A tope, a tope.
Filling two bars, Nava. Lunchy blotter.
Beja.
Dasta vei.
Camila, she otto in chihante.
Jumbly.
Diga, diga, deixa!
Before time. Hola, caca, dice.
How do you do, Your Highness?
Come on, put the bajo.
This boy, give
a hunger, hunger.
Ha, do she?
A tofe, a tofe.
Only give a diva.
Before time, estou fambada. Me com
Guina fish.
Okay, that's just a Fletcher. get in the house. Jessica is mad. You won't be out there. She's mad. So now she's haunting true Scrumptious grave. Now that's crazy.
Elaganda.
Lava!
יש מעבר בזודה?
שזה! גושי פאג צ'ומלה, זזו.
אלא מה עדיין יזוף.
קונק, הוא תודה בג'או!
ביקס, ביקה, בטושיק!
Thank you. No, don't grab a plate of that. That'll make you sick.
אלה קוגה, בטוטון עלי. Siempre buscar de atiso.
¿Qué tú fees a la bujú? ¿Tás me ojudís? ¿Ajá, cuando oye?
Raza, siento.
Medla tosh, das da stuva.
Grasti. Chiam, tu laza.
Kizwa.
This is Nona. Che lo macaia da toia.
Blisti.
Oi, Shoma. Shoma.
Quisit, Eva. Abbas, Eva. Quisit.
Abbas,
Blisti. Quisit, Eva. Abbas,
default. So wow. we can finally get started on season 8. Because she got frightened to death by a ghost, and that's what happened to Maria and later Tony. But as you guys see, that this is what happened, and totally unexpected. I had no control over that. I mean, yes, I sped things up a little bit toward the end, as you guys saw, but yeah, congratulations, Tony, you win season 7, and you are going to move on to the all-star round. So season 8 we'll kick off as soon as I can. And thank you so much for tuning in. My name is Alicia, our ADP. And I will see you guys another time. Have a good night. Bye.